Good afternoon. Thank you. It's a great honor for me to be at this event. Massive thank you to the committee of IISR. I hope the event will run smoothly until the end. Thank you to the moderator, jury members, and meeting participants. Please allow me to introduce myself. My name is Satria Perwira. I am a second year resident at Erlangga University, Indonesia. On this occasion, I will present about the alleged adultery. Coming to background, sexual intercourse is the penetration of the vagina by the penis, regardless of the presence or absence of sperm or semen. In Indonesian criminal law, there are two forms of intercourse. The first is sexual intercourse in marriage, where the wife is not yet able to marry or is under 15 years of age, causing injuries and or causing death. Meanwhile, intercourse outside of marriage has two forms, intercourse with consent and approval. This approval includes rape and sexual intercourse with an unconscious or defenseless woman, while what is approved is adultery. For the case report, on June 6, 2022, a letter requesting a medical examination of alleged adultery from the investigator was received 3 days after the husband found his wife at the inn with another man. From external examination, there were no abnormalities or signs of violence. From the internal examination, we found tiny abrasion irregularly in labium minus. An autopsy was found on examination of the hymen with no abnormalities or signs of violence on the rectal. For the additional examination, a pregnancy test was carried out with a negative result. Vaginal swabs and vaginal irrigation were carried out for later examination at the East Java Police Forensic Laboratory. This is the picture from a genital examination. We found tiny abrasion irregularly in labium minus. We have done low and high vaginal swab, vaginal irrigation, swab sample, irrigation sample, and signing the documents for the evidence proof. For the discussion, signs of sexual intercourse include signs of penetration and signs of ejaculation. These forms can be in a hymen tear, the discovery of ejaculate fluid, either sperm or semen, pregnancy, and the presence of venereal disease. The discovery of sperm fluid is a definite sign of intercourse. If there are no spermatozoa cells, then the proof of the existence of intercourse can be identified by seminal examination. One problem of proving the crime of adultery in Article 284 of the Indonesian Criminal Code is the difficulty of proving the element of the offense adultery. So for the conclusion, we reported one case of alleged adultery. The case was a female approximately 24 years old, 156 centimeters in height, 57 kilograms in weight, and brown in color, and good nutritional status. On external examination, there were no abnormalities or sign of violence. In an internal examination, we found tiny abrasion irregularly in labium minus and an ulcer of the hymen. We have done vaginal swab and vaginal irrigation to find sperm as proof of intercourse. Once again, many thanks to the jury members and the fellow participants. Congratulations to the committee. Please do not hesitate if you have any question. Thank you.